presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, helpful video filters in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you're excited about maybe having the ability to do some things that you didn't know you could do before in ProPresenter 7, go ahead, subscribe to this video, click on the little bell icon to get notifications, and give me a thumbs up while you're at it. So one thing that is really cool about ProPresenter is that they're always adding new features, and quite frankly, this one slipped right past me. Didn't notice it at all until sometime after it came out. Now, I think it was sometime in 2021, but I'm not 100% sure. So if someone noticed it before then, by all means, let me know. I'm not saying that there were no video filters before. I'm just saying I found one that's particularly helpful. So I want to show that to you. So let's head over to my computer and take a look. So before, it was the case that if you had a background video or something, well, here, let me right-click here and let's go into Inspector. That used to be called Media Properties, but now we go into Inspector and we've got info about the video. You can set in and out, stuff like that, but go to Effects here. And under Effects, click this plus button right here. And this should show you all the different ones that you have here. So we can adjust color. You can do the CRT monitor. That's cathode ray tube. That it doesn't have anything to do with any other news stuff. That's makes it look like an old TV. There we go. Color invert, color filter, etc. But the one that I want to concentrate on here is color key. So let's click on that. Now, what color key is it's basically a chroma key and a luma key filter all put together. And you can already see maybe what it's doing here. This used to be white. And if I click that, you'll see that it disappears and reappears. So what it's doing is whatever color I select here, it is making that transparent. Are you starting to get some ideas? So right now it's white, but it doesn't have to be. It could be some other color. So let me click on this, and this is a helpful little thing. We've got an eyedropper here, so I can choose a color. What if I were to choose something kind of bluish here? Okay, now it kind of had a blue tint to the entire video, so it got a lot more than I wanted to. So what we're going to do is we're going to tweak the tolerance so that it only gets basically the sky. Now I could play with that a little bit more to get it to do some more stuff, but what's fun about that is this is applied live. So I can change this key as I need to get it to do different things. But this isn't only on pre-recorded videos. I can also add it. Here, let me turn that off and click here to remove it. I can also do that on live video sources. So let's go down here to video input, and I think, yeah, let me do this one, which should have everything that you see here. So yep, so that shows up here. Now I can right click on this, go into Inspector again, go to Effects again, click on the plus button again, and go to color key right here. And you'll see what I did is I removed all the white, including the white in my hair. Thanks, ProPresenter for rubbing it in that I am very gray. I'm not even 50 yet. Huh. Or I can also, let's change this, click on that, the eyedropper tool again, and let's say I wanted to get rid of all this background right here, and I've done that. So once again, if I wanted to tweak the tolerance to make it ignore more or less, I can. But that's something where maybe from time to time you'll want to perhaps do a chroma key and you don't have a video switcher, or you'll want to do a luma key and you don't have a video switcher. Well, you can do it live in ProPresenter 7. Maybe you want to do a cool chroma key effect for the kids ministry to put the kids in different places. Just set up a camcorder, bring that into ProPresenter, add that filter, and you can remove the background just like that. You would have to do some stuff to actually put that video up on a higher level, so a higher layer rather, so that you could put something behind it, but that could be something fun to do. So that is all about the new helpful video filter that I found in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you so that you can take my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.